Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again. Today I would like to share with you another book cover I have created. I've been asked for medieval style book cover, and it gives me so much pleasure to go to the in the past to try to find some style in medieval which I will love to share. Which I will love to recreate. So I was very inspired by that, but by that age, in the medieval age, those books was very beautiful. They was so much decorated. There was gold to decorate all those pages and decorate covers. I didn't use too much gold on the cover, but I did use few touches in the gold in my book. But before I will show you what is inside, I would like to share with you. I just received from one of my friends very beautiful message. I think the message I received, I'm gonna show you. This is the thing we can do. It can't hurt, I believe, if you will go to your own garden and if you will avoid to make a group of people. You know, now it's kind of dangerous to make groups of people. So if you will go to your own garden and you will try to show respect to all of those people who are fighting, not just people who are ill, but also all those doctors, nurses, policemen, firemen, all those people who are trying to help. I believe this is very nice to do. So if you can share it with your friends, if you are willing to do this one, please do so. I will join the group, not group. I will join this idea and I will definitely do it. I wanted to share this one, so now we can move to this cover. In the past, I did both loads of things, and one of these things were those molds. Beautiful things. They are mostly used in baking, and they are used for chocolate and for making decorations on cakes. I found this one on eBay while ago. I think maybe 2 years ago, maybe. And now when I'm making that tidy up in my craft room, organizing again in my craft room, I found it. And I was thinking, oh, I can use it exactly for that medieval era. So I did use it on my cover and I did use it inside in that book as well. I did use for the mold. I have used this Tonix Studios. It's creative clay. It's white, very soft, beautiful clay. It dries on the air. It's not heavy. It's flexible when it's dried. You can use any kind of colors to change the color of that clay after it's dry, and on the top, to make it more strong, more sturdy, I did use glossy accent on those pieces. I did use walnut stain distress ink and also black distress ink to create some kind of coloring to put it together with this cover. So this is the book I have. The cover I have created, and inside, when I was when I was trying to get some inspiration from those book from a medieval era, I found also amazing manuscripts, and I also found boxes for manuscripts which were amazing. They were so gorgeous. And I took inspiration from those boxes. That inspiration is here in this pocket. Some of these boxes for manuscripts, they had the cover like see-through. I'm not sure how they did it. I think it was box half from paper, and that circle was made. It was looks like from wood. I think it did looked that way when I saw those pictures. So I tried to recreate it using my dies. I don't remember the name of these dies, but I will try to find it. And then I found very, very interesting manuscript, and I downloaded few pictures from that manuscript, and I did reprinted those pages and put them together exactly how it was right down in the on that, you know, description of that book. Here you can see that writing. And that book had 340, I'm not sure how many, 340 something pages. It was very large one, made from wood pieces. It was small wood pieces where was some writing, and they were put together with a long thread, and it was somehow wrapped together. So then when you wanted to read it, you just need to like unflop them. And always was one side printed, that other side was like blank. So I do have here a few of those pages. And I did create it for this teeny, mini, small manuscript. I did create this holder. This is actually just what I was thinking, how I will put it to this book. So I just did created this like holder. And here we've got pocket, and as you can see, I did use some gold, golden strips, because, you know, those books from that medieval era, they was really beautifully beautifully decorated with gold and with all kind of colors. But it was always just a touch. It wasn't, mostly it wasn't full page or full book. There wasn't too many colorful images, but just those touches. So I tried to recreate it here. And I did my teeny, teeny small layout for this picture. It's like flipping up, and it's like writing space. Here I've got another tag, and it's pocket behind, and I've got there another tag, and one small pocket. It's also here. And when we open it, we've got belly band here. And I did create those holders in that medieval era, when they had those traveling bags. They did use loads of those leather strips, and that wrapping with those, you know, leather strips with holes, and wrapping all together with some thread. So I was inspired by that wrapping of those traveling bags. And here we've got another beautiful print from that medieval age. Okay, go there. And here we've got two pockets here. That's smaller. On the top is a little bit smaller one. And here is bigger. Yeah. And we can open it this way. And here it's another page I've got. I did use here a embossing folder, and here on the top I've got another that mold. Oh, it's folding down, I'm sorry. So here I've got that another mold, and I used again that walnut stain and glossy accent on the top to make it more sturdy. And here is another, it was like manuscript box with that see-through. So I use it for my teeny, mini, small pocket. And here a small tag. And I used two magnets to hold it. They, of course, they haven't magnets at that time, I think. I believe they haven't magnets. But because I do have magnets, I use them here for closure. And here we've got another pocket with two images from medieval era. I really love this one. It's gorgeous, gorgeous drawing. Here is just some page from, I think, Athanasi Kircheri book, I believe. And here I try to recreate another box. It did had a long strip of leather here on that other side, which was used for hanging around your neck, so they was able to carry this teeny mini small package with, when they wanted to open, they had to, you know, move this small bead down and then open it, and inside they had those manuscripts. At that time wasn't so many people who was able to read or write, so anyone who did carry some book was like very wise person. So here I do have, for those I'm not sure if they was called priest, it was those people who are walking from the city to the city, who shared, you know, all knowledge they had. So they did carry those small manuscripts in bags like this. So it's here in this pocket. I'm gonna place it back. And here on this side we do have another two images from, yeah, this is Athanasi Kircheri. He was very famous and at that medieval age, in 17th century. He was Germany writer, alchemist, teacher, a doctor. He did so many things. He knew so many things, and he did wrote about 40 books. At that time it was quite a lot. He was very, very good writer, and his books was amazing. There was so many gorgeous drawings. So this is from one of his books, and I think this one was from one of his books as well. I think this was about live in India, if I do remember that right. I think it was from India books. So here, and I try to recreate, you know, those messages from the town to the town, which kings was sending via their messengers, and they always put to the end that sealed stamped. I don't have that sealing kit, that you know, that kit with that wax and with those stamps. So I tried to use my glue, hot glue gun. I just put a little bit of that hot glue on this ribbon. I let it dry a little bit, and then I used one of my stamps. Hope you can see that. And then on that top, that gold, it's a Rubin buff. Gold Rubin buff. So I tried to recreate it with my hot glue gun. And here we've got another pocket with another manuscript. It's again that see-through. And here another that small manuscript with writing. It's just, you know, few pages from that manuscript. These was very big books. They had many pages, and at the start they had learning how to write, and then there was, you know, so many different informations in those books. So I just tried to reprint a few of these pages. So this is my sharing for today. I know it doesn't have many pages, but I hope you like few different techniques I have used in this book. I hope you like that very grungy style, because I really enjoy to do that this book. After a few months where I haven't, I think, any grungy like this, I really enjoyed to do this one. Here on that spine I did use that rusty patina, and I used also I did use this alcohol ink, teakwood, this one. No. And those small pieces, they are drawing pins. In the past, I did order on Amazon the marker. Yes, you can hear me well. The marker. I did order this Posca, Uniposca white marker. Bigger one. Not this teeny, mini, tiny tip, but with normal marker. Instead of receiving this marker with that bigger tip, I did receive this one, and I wasn't able to send it back. That was very weird. So I saved those pins when I didn't know how to use them. And when I tried to create this book, it was just somehow came to my head that why do not use these? I can use the hammer from that other side, and I can hammer those ends, those sharp ends. And I believe I really like that look. So here you can see how it looks like with drawing pins. So this is my sharing for today. I hope you are taking care about yourself. Please, if you are able to do so, join me at 8:30 p.m. tonight to show a little bit of respect to all those who are fighting with this pandemic illness. Have a wonderful time. Please take care about yourself and see you next time. Bye.